Family being haunted by Darth Maul with a crazy Nicolas Cage hairdo. Scary?
Ooh!
Insidious.
Yeah.
I thought this movie was just going to be like, kind of like a regular haunted
film. Oh, spooky ghost. Cat yeah. jumps out.
Yeah, it just seemed like a
run-of-the-mill
mediocre film.
And then like...
And it was also confusing because it was directed by James Wan. He did the original Saw. So anything you expect out of that guy is blood gushes.
I mean, even in Dead Sentence.
Something like
the Kevin Bacon movie.
Yeah, it was still like unbelievably violent and bloody.
Dead Silence with the ripping out the tongues.
I mean, but this, it holds back on the gore a whole lot. And
it's just scares.
Yeah, it's just generally scary. It's not just like jump scares.
It's not just like, you know, someone opens the door and you know,
boom. But it's a genuinely scary film. I mean, I haven't seen just an all around just great, just fun to watch movie that's gonna scare the pants off you basically without all the blood and all the jump scares. It's
been a while.
Yeah, it's a basic homage to like an old school haunting film. It's like this kid's like they're being haunted by like this creepy thing. I mean, it looks like Darth Maul and crack,
but
and
basically,
Nicolas Cage hair and Bangkok Dangerous.
Bangkok Dangerous. They think that their house is haunted because Right when he got there, the son, like, went into a coma.
Yeah. I mean, like, this guy Dalton, like, while he's playing, he hears, like, noises in the attic and, like, goes to investigate. And there's, like, and it's all scary and you hear a bunch of noises and stuff. And you hear him screaming because it's, like, the shadowy character or whatever. And it turns out, like, he's being haunted. And
It's not the house. It's the son.
But basically, it's... To sum it up without giving too many details, if you want a haunting film, just a film that you're going to watch it and you're really going to enjoy it and it's going to really scare you, not just gross you out and not just make shit jump at you like the new Nightmare on Elm Street film, this really is the film for you. Like, James Wan, it's...
It's like mastery done.
It's really well done. A lot of people may not think so.
I haven't, been, like... jumpy, scared.
Oh, yeah. I haven't been genuinely scared, because I'm usually grossed out by films, because that's how they get the shocks nowadays, but this is just... really an homage to old-school films.
And, like, this scene, this, like, movie is, like, unwatchable at any time, because there's even daylight scares.
Yeah,
With a creepy old man dancing in the...
You don't know what's going to come... You don't know what's going to come next, really. I mean, I didn't think it was predictable. I thought it was really well done. It... scared the shit out of me at some points. I don't get scared. I mean, really.
You know, like the crib scene?
Yeah, I mean, it's... But I'd have to say, James Wan's one of his best films. It's up there with Saw. That and Saw 1.
And
I really liked it. I haven't seen a true scary film in a while, and this did it for me. And I'd give it, like, a 5 out of 5, just for the sheer effort it did, and just by the overall creepiness of it, without having to resort to... corny, like, jump scares and all-out gore. It just
was
scary for being scary.
Yeah, like, while I was watching that, even, like, the credits, you know, built it up with the classic violin scary music that...
It's good
it's
film.
It's just really scary. Like, I haven't been jumpy in a while, so yeah, I'll give it 5 out of 5.
I gotta give a shout-out to Patrick Wilson, because he was awesome in this film, and... I love
everyone did a good job.
Yeah, everyone, really.
Even the Leigh-Whannell, the writer.
But, yeah, 5 out of 5. Go see it. If you want to see a real scary movie that you're just going to love,
go see
this movie. It's awesome.
You know, don't go see Hop
Yeah, don't go see Hop.
Or,
if you're a horror fan, you're going to enjoy this.
And after this, go see Source Code. That needs to get seen.
Yeah. People, we will give a review on that in a minute. But, overall, Insidious, great. We loved it. Oh, and glad to be back. You too.
Yeah, so he's back.
I'm back.
It's.
We'll go more into that in a vlog, but good to be back. 5 out of 5. Have a good one, YouTube.